All right, is there anybody in here yet? Can you guys hear me? I don't have my other laptop. My kids are trying to get the laptop. Can you guys hear me? So I don't know. We're gonna have to look at comments here for a second, and then we'll just go. I'm trying to find my laptop or my phone, and my kids are. I always lose my damn laptop. Can you guys hear me? Most importantly, can you hear me? The most important thing is, can you hear me? And then I'll deal with that here in a second. Yay, nay. Yes, you can hear me? No, you can't. Da 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 da. Da 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 da. It's the D O double G. You know all that stuff, right? Can you guys hear me? We're just gonna do this then. I just want to make sure you guys can hear me, so let me know so we can get rolling. Just want to make sure you guys can hear me. You can hear me. Okay, you can hear me. Get rid of that one. All right, so you motherfuckers can hear me. You're just not saying anything. So let's talk about gold real quick. And I was in that YouTube stream with a couple people that I like to tease a little bit, and they were talking about they were trying to kind of mock me a little bit, which is fine. They can mock me all they want. I don't really care about that. But I told them I was in gold cells the whole time I was telling you all this stuff, and they're like, "No, we don't believe that." So we're just gonna pull up the account history here, and we'll pull up a custom period, and we'll just do it from yesterday to today, and we'll check this out here. Okay, it's not a bad 24 hours on this small account of 650 bucks. This is a live account, so you can see there's a gold sell that we made good money on. And here's the one I was talking about with this guy in this chat room. All the time last night I was screaming about that. I was actually in sells. You can see that sell right there at 1916.78, taken all the way down to 1898.79. You can see a sell at 1918. Or was that a buy? Was that a buy? Yeah, that was a buy and lost money, right? Because again, you lose money. I mean, that's part of the game, right? Here's another couple sells right there. There was a buy there. So sell at 1923. So I took sells just because my bias is to the long side doesn't mean I can't sell gold. And I took multiple sell opportunities on gold yesterday. But there was a guy in there and he wanted to come in here saying he was gonna be cool, and that's fine. Come in here, but just because I was goading you a little bit, to be honest with you. I was in sales the whole time, so I thought that was kind of funny because, he's like, you were saying buys the whole time, and I still believe in the buys. I still believe that overall the trend to the long side, to the trend, higher time frame trend is still an uptrend. I still believe that with every fiber of my being. Because that's what the higher time frame charts say on gold. But that again doesn't mean we can't sell gold when those opportunities present themselves. And so that's what we did. So, and as you can see, again, when I stream, and I really don't like streaming, but when I stream, you see a live terminal up here. Okay, when there's no hiding behind TradingView, there's no hiding behind anything. In my stream, when I take a trade, you're going to see it. You're going to see the terminal up. This is my MT4 terminal. This is a live account. Okay, this isn't no fake HOMO FOMO trading. This is a live account. Okay, this is a smaller account that I have. I have multiple accounts, and this is a smaller one. But you can see right there, if I point right there and move this over, you can see it's a live account. Okay, there's no FOMO HOMO trading here. That's not what we do in here. If you want FOMO HOMO trading, you go somewhere else. There's plenty of streams to go to where you can get FOMO HOMO trading. That's not how we do things in this stream. So in this stream, we take trades based on what we see, right? And in 6 minutes, if the 15-minute pattern on gold closes like this with that wick at the top of the candle longer than the body of the candle with no tail at the bottom, we will be taking another sell right there, right? If that happens in the next 6 minutes, we will absolutely be taking another trade on that. Because that's what the numbers say to do, right? And then your targets would be back down here in the lows. we'll see. We have 6 minutes left in a 15-minute candle, but we're going to get multiple opportunities tonight to take trades. So I'm excited about that. I'm excited to get multiple opportunities to take trades. And I need to get my other laptop so I can see what's going on in the, if there is anything going on in the chat room, right? If there's anything going on, there's barely anyone here. But we'll see. We'll see if we get some trades and we'll take the trades live, and because we're not pussies and we never will be pussies. But right now it looks like we're on this, on the US 30. The US 30 did give a pattern on the 15 minute that this 15 minute that closed prior. It was a nice sell pattern. That's a good sell pattern. And right now I'm down 44 points on it, right? So that was a nice sell pattern on the 15 minute US 30. It's had a lot of time to try and break this level, multiple hours to try and break that level. So I think in order for it to go up higher, if it wants to, it probably needs to break lower first. But it could go against me, and that's fine. My stop loss is 200 points from where I got in. So I still have another 150 points that it can go against me without stopping me out. So we'll just see what happens on that one. We're not really trading the 15-minute chart, but because streaming is boring if you just trade the one-hour chart, we have been taking entries off the 15-minute chart based on the same pattern, right? Because if you have to wait till every one-hour candle closes, you're going to be waiting for an hour, and then what do you fucking do for that hour? It's kind of boring, right? So it's just a little bit more exciting when you stream to do it on the 15-minute chart, because then you get four opportunities per hour instead of one opportunity per hour. So it just makes it a little bit more exciting, I guess. Maybe it's not more exciting. I don't know. Maybe it's dumber, and maybe I shouldn't be doing that. But I don't mind doing it. The pattern should play out the same no matter what, right? I mean, if we truly believe in the pattern, we believe that it's 85% accurate, which I do, then it will work on any time frame, any of it. So we just need to wait for the pattern, and then we'll take the trades, and we'll see what happens. And if we lose on trades, we lose on trades, right? We're not, again, not afraid to do that. I'm not going that far down. That would just fry my brain, to be honest. Okay, so on gold, looking at a four-hour chart, gold came down to this four-hour support level. I'm going to put this red line on the support level from around March 29th of 2022. At around 1889, a little bit above there, right? So that was a pretty significant support level that gold came down to. Okay, that was, if you look at your chart, you can't see all the way back on March 29th on my chart because of whatever the hell that is. But if you look around March 29th on the 4 hour time frame, it was a pretty significant level at 1891 area. It's bounced off that area so far, right? So if you're looking at targets to the upside on gold with this bounce up, you're gonna look at these levels here at 1915 area. So we're trading in between the range of 1891 and 1915. So we'll see what happens, right? If it pulls back here again and gives us another buy signal down there, we'll buy it. If it just doesn't give us a buy signal, breaks above 1815, pulls back to 1815, we'll buy it. And we could possibly have some sells if it comes up there and gives us the sell signal. So right now it's just a waiting game. And if we were trading on the one-hour chart, we'd be waiting a lot longer. So we do the 15-minute chart just because it's a little bit more exciting for people. Just a little bit more exciting for people. We like excitement here. We like it. It's great. We love excitement. Okay, so the three charts I have up right now, oil looks like it's a possible buy on the 15-minute chart. We'll see if it pops up a little bit higher. So let's go look at the GJ. The GJ doesn't look like it's going to give us any pattern on a 15-minute this time. Let's go look at the pound Aussie. Pound Aussie doesn't look like it's going to give us anything. So really the only thing that looks halfway decent is a buy on oil. And we'll wait and see in the next 2 minutes if it just pops up maybe another 2 or 3 points to clear that wick at the top, because we don't want a wick at the top. So we'd want it to go a little bit higher. You know, let's see, what am I doing here? We'd want it to go a little bit higher. Maybe another 3 points or so. And I don't know if we're going to get it. So this candle is kind of, it's suspect. But you do have a lot of rejection happening in that area, right? You have you have higher lows. Every time that candle is making that tail, those tails are higher lows, higher lows, higher lows. And so it's possible that we might get that opportunity, and we will absolutely take that trade. In fact, I was at 58 there for a second, and I liked that one a little bit better. I probably will end up taking this trade, to be honest with you. I like the pattern that it's forming. I like the higher highs, right? That's forming right there. So, but now it's just, pop up just to like maybe up to 98.60. I think we're just going to take the damn trade though. We'll see. There it is. So the question is, do we take it? I'm going to take it. Okay, I'm going to take a buy on it on oil at what the hell? What did I just buy? Did I just do the wrong one? No, I didn't. Okay, it's right there. It's on the bottom there. Okay, there it is right there. Okay, so now we got to kind of look to where we want our stops to be on this 15-minute oil trade, and we want the stops to be below this, probably the low of this tail, which is at 97.88. Whoo, whoo, whoo. So that's a really big 15-minute trade. But I absolutely want to give this trade time to breathe. So I'm going to place my stop at 97.50. So it's going to be about 110-point stop loss. I know for some people they can't handle that, and I really don't care. It's not my job. Just lower your lot size if you can't handle that high of trade. But we'll see. And again, maybe we'll lose, right? Losses happen. Losses are okay. Losses are no big deal, right? Oops, trying to get this right here. Okay, so you're seeing a live trade taken in a live account, live terminal, and we'll see how it goes. Okay. That was really the only setup we had at the 15-minute close there. So we'll see what happens with it. I think it's awesome that Twitter is going to be not run by a bunch of left-wing morons and that free speech wins the day. You know how I feel about free speech. That's why I hate streaming on YouTube, because YouTube's a bunch of communist bastard anti-free speech people too. So I think that if Elon Musk is going to make it free speech and bring back free speech and not censor conservative voices, I think it's great. I mean, if you have the Ayatollah of Iran that's able to, tweet, but President Trump can't tweet, but like mass murderers and genocide people over in Iran and all these other places, they can tweet, but President Trump can't. I mean, that doesn't make any sense to me. But not a lot of things make sense to me. So it doesn't make a lot of sense to me, but not, I mean, this fucking world doesn't make much sense to me. I mean, he made a comment today that he wouldn't go back to Twitter even if they wanted him to go back. So he made a comment that said he wouldn't go back. So I don't know. I don't really care. That doesn't make me money, right? That doesn't make me money. So I really don't care if he goes back or if he doesn't. It has no effect on my trading or no effect on anything, right? So I could give two shits at what he does. I really don't care. But I need to get my other laptop out so I can just stop going back to see the comments in the thing. So let me go see if I can find my laptop again, guys. I'll be right back, and then we'll continue trading. We can't take another trade for at least 15, at least 12 minutes anyway. So I'll be back in a few minutes here. All right, we're back, guys. I'm getting my drink, ready to rock and roll. See what happens. See if we get some trades here. Busting out the Dr. Pepper and coconut cream. Again, because I'm addicted to that right now, and I shouldn't drink it. It's terrible for me. But I don't fucking care. I just don't fucking care about it. I don't really don't give a fuck about it much these days. So, I'm in that I don't give a fuck mode right now. I really am. Just, you know, it's just one of those deals. I just don't really care. Maybe I should, you know, maybe I should start caring a lot more about a lot more things. I probably won't. It wasn't a Frosty Boy. It was a Dr. Pepper and coconut cream. So, it was not a Frosty Boy. Or, I mean, maybe it is a Frosty Boy. I don't even know what you call a Frosty Boy. So, it very well could be. All right, so we got 8 minutes left in this candle. We'll see how oil ends up playing out. Gold is, you know, we're still in that slow period. There's not a lot going on right now. It's pre-London, and so I don't expect a whole hell of a lot to go on. But we'll see what happens. You'll see this one on here on the GJ. There's a buy in the GJ from 162.58 that I'm up on right now. And I'm going to show you guys why I took the GJ trade. I might just consider myself the GJ King now too. I might just consider myself the GJ King because I make more pips on the GJ than these morons do that stream on YouTube for sure. So I might just label myself the GJ King too. Okay, so there was a... Yeah, right here. All right, that 50-minute candle on the GJ definitely had a tail at the bottom of the candle. Tail at the bottom of the body of the candle that was longer than the body of the candle. So I took that trade. I'm up 12 pips on it. So if I like if I was most of these YouTube streamers, I'd take it out like a pussy, right? If I was most of these YouTube streamers, I'd be running for the hills right now because I got 12 pips. But because we don't wear girls' panties and we're not pussies, and we don't take trades out to 10 pips like little pussies, we're going to hold this trade. Because there's a good chance that we could get a pretty good move back up on this, on the GJ. So if we get the move up on the GJ that we're looking for, the next major support level would be this level here that I'm going to draw a red line on. I don't know if I think you'll be able to see it. Then that's the next significant level at 162.99 from right there just yesterday, right? That's a pretty significant level. If it breaks that level and it goes higher, then obviously you're looking at these highs up here, or the swing high at 63.39, possibly at 63.63. So I want to be in that trade, if at all possible, right? Because I think it has a lot of room to go. If you look at, again, the account history on this account, just for yesterday or today or whatever the hell you want to call it, I don't really give a damn. You'll see a really nice GJ trade as well. So let's pull this up again. Let's pull up the history. And you'll see, I'm trying to see where the GJ trade is. Okay, there it is right there. It was a sell at 164.46. And I don't, again, know if you'll be able to see this. And I don't really give a damn if you can see it or not. Right, 164.46 that I took out at 163.32. So I got over 100 points on that, which is pretty cool. It would take those YouTube streamers like 10 days of 10 pips, not losing at all, to equal what we did on the GJ in one trade. Yeah. So we had a really nice sell on the GJ for 100 points, and then we had another sell on it for 40 points right here at 163.12. And we took it out at 162.61, so we made another 40 bucks on that one in this small account. So we made 130 pips on the GJ, it looks like, because it looks like those are the only two GJ trades. So 140 points on the GJ. You know, you have YouTube streamers that are all happy about making 250 points for the whole month of April. Woohoo, we've netted 250 pips. Well, yeah, that's great, but I mean, I've netted 140 pips on the GJ in 24 hours. And we're about to get more. So that's great that you netted 240 for the whole month of April, but you're way behind the game, right? I mean, we did that in 24 hours. We did 500 points just today. So it's really nice that you did that. Congratulations to you. You should feel really warm and proud of yourself that you did that, but you're way behind the game. Way behind. So the GJ is working really well. The US 30 is obviously not working very well. My sell on the US 30 is not working, but that's fine. I'm not worried about it. If it ends up taking me out, it takes me out. I don't care. I don't get concerned about that stuff. It's just trades. The setup was there, and I took the setup, and if I lose, I lose. It's not a big deal. But the oil trade's working that we took. We're up 10 pips on that. If we were 10 pip pussy traders, like most of the people on Instagram or YouTube, supposed gurus, we'd be running for the hills right now at 10 pips, right? We'd be like, oh my gosh, this is so awesome. It's like a prom dress on prom night falling off, right? This is so great. But we're not pussies, right? We're not pussies. So we don't do that. Not in this stream. Plenty of other streams you can go to, like I say all the time, to get pussy trades. Plenty of other streams you can go to that will provide you with dumbass analysis and stupid ass trades. So if you don't like what we do here, you're more than happy to go somewhere else, right? I mean, I think it's great that you guys are here. If you don't like what we're doing here, you can kiss my middle-aged white ass and you can go somewhere else. All right. So we got two more minutes on this candle close. And then we'll see what happens. We'll see if we get another trade. But definitely not a Frosty Boy. It's a Dr. Pepper and coconut cream, like creamer stuff. And it's disgusting and I shouldn't be drinking it. It's probably going to kill me. But I love it. But it's probably going to kill me. That's probably why I had nasty heartburn last night. I was in DC's stream last night. DC Trading or whatever. Seems like a pretty good dude. So if you guys don't like and follow that guy, seems like a pretty solid guy. Let's go check out DC. Let's go tell these people to get in here again. So he seems like a fair enough guy, right? Maybe he's not. Maybe he's not, right? Maybe he's pulling the wool over, but he seems like a pretty good dude. So we'll give him a shot. We'll give him a chance, right? It's DC Trading. So I'm going to get rid of this for a second. I'm going to go to DC Trading and DC Trading and Company right here. So he has 916 subscribers, and he does the London session. But I was in there for a long time last night. Oh, and we haven't done our theme song yet for tonight, so we got to do our theme song. All right, we always do the theme song. This is like our national anthem in this stream.
Well, I was born and raised in Scranton, PA. Lifeguard by the pool is where I spent my days. Till a dude named Corn Pop, who wasn't that cool, started making trouble at the swimming pool. So I took a chain, wrapped it around my legs. They're hairier than my other legs. Black kids would touch them. Come on, man. Then I got on a train and moved to D.C. Jirok Jabrama gave a job to me. I shuffled
around and
sucked fingertips. Made a big speech, kissed a boy on the lips. What are you looking at? I wrote the damn bill.
Yeah, you did.
I hold the ladies tight and sniff all their hairs. First person American to fall up the stairs. Ran for president, I was a winner. Winner was me.
Now I sit at my desk as the Prince of Prezi. You know the thing.
You know the thing. Come on, get your face out of your head.
That is our theme song in this channel. That is our absolute theme song. So let's see what we got going on here. Okay, so the next 15-minute candle close will also coincide with being a one-hour candle close, right? So we're going to switch the charts over to the one-hour candle close because the one-hour candle is obviously the one I like to take the most trades on. So because the one-hour candle will give us some signs, we'll switch back over to the one-hour candle. But again, we can't do anything for another, 13 minutes? But we'll switch everything over to the one-hour candle and see what we got on the one-hour candle going towards 11 p.m. Eastern time, I guess. I don't know what time it is. It's 11 p.m. Eastern time, right? It will be 11 p.m. Eastern. So. Do anybody have any questions? I mean, do anybody have any questions about some of the things that we've talked about already? If you do, just type it into the chat. I can't really see anything right now. But if you have any questions, just let me know. But it's the simplest trading. Grand Theft. Do you remember Grand Theft when we did that week before I went on vacation to Hawaii and Alaska? And I think you said we went 34 for 36 that week in the stream. And he was trading the 15-minute chart, right? So we went. I think it was like 34 for 36 one week before I left to go on vacations. And I think we were like 34 for 36 on the stream. If I remember right. You know, my memory isn't as good as it used to be. I'm an old fart now, so I don't, my memory's not as good. But if memory serves me right, we were like 34 for 36. Yep. And he kept track of it. So if you bastards have a problem with that, you can go talk to him. Right? If you bastards have a problem with it, go talk to Grand Theft. Right? He's the one that keeps track of it. Stop being a pussy. Go talk to him about it. Right? Yo. All right. Thanks, buddy. Can you give this back to mom?
Sure.
All right. Good night. See you in the morning.
Me too. Unless if I see you in the middle of the night.
Yeah. Hopefully not. All right. Hey, we leave the door open a little bit, please. That was my 13-year-old going to bed, so I've got my phone back now, and that's nice. I like to have my phone. So yeah, and then we had a fun day making fun of people as always. Call me an asshole. Like I said, I don't really care what you think of me. But we had a fun day making fun of Controller FX. But we're gonna ease off on him a little bit. He sent me a private message on Instagram and kind of just whined like a little bitch to stop bothering him, stop talking about him. Which is kind of funny because he's like, stop lying about me. I'm not lying about you. You do trade from your parents' house in your bedroom. That's a fact. That's not being dishonest about you. That's a fact. And the other fact that I said is your trading net challenge, when you did your trading net challenge, you absolutely sucked. It was a complete and utter disaster. That's not untrue. We have the proof of it. You just have to go to trading net. So again, I mean, what is it that I was untruthful about? You do trade from your parents' bedroom, your parents' house in your bedroom. Fact. And your trading net challenge sucked. What is untruthful about that? I'll show you guys the message he sent me. There's nothing untruthful about that. Here it is right here. Look at this. Look at this. He sends me this picture from his Discord group or wherever, and he says, stop spreading lies, IMO. This was the reply, not whatever you posted. What is it that I'm lying about? And so I just asked him very, very basic questions, as you can see right there, right? The very basic questions are, yes or no, you trade from your parents' house. Very simple question. Yes or no, your trading net challenge was a disaster. Those aren't lies, kid. It's the truth. And it is. So how am I lying about him? He doesn't like it. He made him cry. Stop spreading lies. Stop spreading lies about me. Tell me what it is that I'm spreading lies of. I mean, everything I said about you is true. You do trade from your parents' house in your bedroom. You stream from your bedroom. That's a fact. Anyways, don't you hate it when facts kind of get in the way of your fantasies of success and love and peace and all that different stuff, and it come to find out that you really aren't that good, you actually fucking suck? I mean, that would probably hurt my feelings to realize that I'm a dumbass and I really don't know what the fuck I'm talking about, and I'm just totally bullshitting people. And that would probably hurt pretty bad for me, I guess. I mean, I guess that would kind of suck to realize that my life is a complete fucking failure. Because I'm 22 years old and I live at my parents' house. I mean, that's pretty pathetic. To be honest with you. I mean, I'm sure he's actually a really good dude. And I'm sure, you know. But holy shit, dude. You know, get your own place, man. You're 22 and you claim to make that much money. Get your own damn place, man. What are you waiting for, right? Get your own damn place, dude. It'll be better for you. But he apparently doesn't want to do that. He wants to live with his parents the rest of his life. And you know what? Good on you, dude. Good on you, man. Good on you. You do whatever makes you happy, I guess. Okay, what time it is? We got 7 minutes left. Good on you, little man. Good on you. If that's what you have to do to make yourself feel successful, you know. Hey, Mom, can you keep it quiet? I'm trying to stream here. Mom, can you keep it quiet? I'm trying to stream on YouTube from my bedroom, and you're being very distracting. And it's gotta kind of suck. So, you know, maybe I should be sympathetic towards him. Maybe I should just be sympathetic. You know, I mean, you have serious mental health issues. If you're making 20 to 40 grand a month that you claim you're making, and you live with your parents at 22, you have serious mental health issues. So maybe I should just be more kind to him. Maybe we should kill him with kindness. Kill him with kindness. I don't kill him with kindness. I kill him with reality. I kill people with reality checks. Because people need reality checks. People really, really need reality checks. And I feel like I'm giving a service because I'm helping them. I'm giving them a reality check. I feel like I'm actually doing a service. Maybe I'm not. Maybe I'm just an asshole. And that's fine. Call me whatever you want. No one fucking cares what you think. So do whatever you want, man. Oh, look at oil go. Okay, so now on oil, did everyone see that we took that trade live? Did everybody see that? Did you guys see that? We took that trade live, right? We're up 50 points on oil right now. Who effing does that? What streamer does that? Answer me that question. What streamer actually shows the platform, the MT4 platform, and takes live trades on their MT4 platform? What other YouTube fucking streamer does that? Shows a live terminal while they're trading. What other streamer does that? Please tell me that. What other streamer does that? Yeah, no, Little Boy Blue doesn't. Little Boy Blue. Little Boy Blue. So now we're going to place our stops on oil at plus 10. Okay, because we want to make money. So we're going to do it plus 10 because then we feel good about ourselves, because then we make plus 10 like Little Boy Blue and all of his group. And we feel good about ourselves because we made at least 10 pips, just like Little Boy Blue. So we're going to change our stop loss, modify, to 98.83. So no matter what, we'll make 10 pips, and we will feel good about ourselves because we'll have traded a 10-pip scalp trade like Little Boy Blue does. Little Boy Blue. It's beautiful, right? It's stinking beautiful. Thank you very much. We appreciate it. So there's a live trade, motherfuckers. There's a live trade. Get those people in any other stream to show you a live terminal while they're trading. You will never see anyone else do what we're doing here. Never. Because they hide behind TradingView and they're pussies. Let's just be honest. Let's stop clowning around in the Forex market, because this market and this industry has a really bad reputation, right? Let's stop clowning around and just start being brutally honest with people. The reason you don't show trades is because you're fucking cowards. Just be honest with people. It'll be better for you, right? The reason you don't do it is because you're clowns. I want to get Deluxe Trader in here. The reason you don't do it is because you're clowns. The reason they don't do it is because they're fucking clowns. Just, again, this industry needs a little bit of brutal honesty in it, and I'm happy to provide that for people. I'm happy to provide it for people. I think it's great. I think it's wonderful. I think it's wonderful. See, the nice thing about it, we're at plus 10. We just let that trade go. We just forget about it because we don't really care, right? Little boy blue. Little boy blue. I think he loves us. I think secretly he has a man crush on us. I think secretly he has a man. All of his butt buddies listen to and look at all my content on Instagram. All of his little butt buddies, Marcus and Wixie9, every time I post a story, they're right there looking at it. They're looking at it. They want real man stuff. And they don't get it from him. They don't get it from him. I don't blame them. They want real man stuff. They want, you know, non-panty trading. And they don't get it from that stream. So they come to mine. Or they come to view my stuff because they wanna feel like a man for once in their life. I mean, gosh, you know, I mean, again, how can you blame them? For once in their life, they kind of want to feel like a man, because they aren't for the most part. So every now and again, they want to feel like a man, and good for them. Again, good for them. We appreciate that. You know, I mean, I sometimes want to feel like a man, right? It's good and healthy for you to feel like a man sometimes. It's good and healthy for you. And then I love when the YouTube streamers too are like, can we get the likes up, guys? Can we get the likes up? Come on, there's 60 people in here and there's only 40 likes. Hey, guess what? I'm going to tell all 7 people in here, you better fucking dislike this stream, because I don't care. Dislike it. In fact, I'm going to dislike my own stream right now. We used to do this all the time. There's three. So right now, you're going to notice this. There's 1 hour candle close. I don't see anything on there. I don't see anything on there. GA, right? That's the GA, or is that G? Oh, pound yen. I don't see anything maybe on the pound yen. Nothing on the pound yen on the 1 hour. So let's go look at the pound Aussie. Is that going to be the same damn thing? Pound Aussie on the 1 hour has nothing. So no trades on the 1 hour chart. So now we'll just revert everything back to the 15 minute chart. We'll start looking at 15 minute chart till that next 1 hour candle close. Really simple, right? So anyways, I'm going to dislike my own stream because, again, I don't care. I really don't care. I don't do this because I need followers or I want followers. I could care less about that. So let's go to, you can see the studio right here. And it looks like you can do likes. And I'm going to dislike my own stream. You're true. I can't tell you what to do, but I'm going to dislike it. There you go. I disliked my own stream. Because, I don't care. Don't. I got to get the Trump impression going again. Don't. I don't care at all. It's going to be bigly. It's going to be huge. It's going to be bigly. It's going to be bigly. It's going to be huge. Right? So let's go back to the history. Ooh, oil is popping up even higher. So that's awesome. So let's go to trade history again. We'll just go from yesterday to today. This is a $3,000 account, $3,100 account. Okay. I'll show it to you guys because I'm not afraid of doing that. I'm not a homo and I'm not a FOMO. See, it's a live account. As you can see, it's a live account. You'll see at the top left and you'll see that the balance is $3,072. And okay. So it's not a huge account. I have multiple accounts, but this one's not a huge one. But you can see today what we did. We did $650 today. Not a bad day, right? There's all the trades. You can see them all. Again, because I'm not a pussy. I will show you everything. Because I'm not a pussy. You see all those trades. How many trades did we take today? Let's see. Let's just look at it. I'm a trading fool. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. And it doesn't mean that I took all of those trades today. It might have been some that I had held right a little bit longer and took out today. So it doesn't necessarily mean that all of those trades were taken today. But it's possible that they were. I don't know. I really don't care. It was a good day. If you can make $650. Hey, JJ, what's up, brother? If you can make $650 a day on a $3,000 account. Do you know what's... Just so everyone knows, too. If you make $650 a day, 5 days a week for 4 weeks, that's pretty good fucking money, isn't it? So let's just do the calculator. $650 a day. And you're not going to do it every day, right? But you do that times five. That's $3,200 a week times four. It's 13 grand a month. I mean, that's not bad. I have no bills, so I'll take that. So JJ, you were talking last night about in DC Trading stream about mentorships and everything. I didn't want to talk to you about mentorships in DC's stream because I didn't think that was respectful to him, and I hope you understand that. I'm not there to promote me or to promote my stuff when I'm in his stream. But guess what? We're in my stream tonight. So do you have questions for me about mentorship or anything like that? Because now we're in my stream, right? We can talk about whatever we want. But I'm not going to disrespect him by making it about me and his stream, which it kind of ended up being about last night anyway. And that's not exactly how I want that to go down. So, but if you have any questions about, I do have a paid signal group. It includes 6 one-on-ones. And it's $399 for lifetime. Okay. Gaz is going to freak out. He's like, what the fuck? Why am I, you know? So it's $399 for lifetime. You'll get 6 one-on-one sessions, 1 hour. And I will also take that $400. It's mine, right? Because you're paying for signals, but I will invest that money and you'll get 50% of the profits. And I will give you the investor password to the account and you can see it. Gaz is like, what the fuck? Why are you doing this fucking now? Heavy trader beef, huh? LOL. What do you mean, heavy trader beef? Kush J. You can still have a lifetime membership, brother. You know that. You just send me a message on Telegram. You still have that. You and I had a little arguments, and we went after each other a little bit, but you know I love you. And I mean, you know, I wouldn't have a baby with you. That might be taken a little bit too far, but... You know, I wouldn't have sex with you. I wouldn't suck your dick. But, you know, we had our hard times, and I'm over that now. If you want to talk to me about that, then we can do that. Send me a message on Instagram or Telegram, whatever the hell you want to do. But Kush J, what are you talking about? Heavy. Kush J, what are you talking about? Heavy trader beef, huh? LOL. I don't know what you're talking about. It would be a comeback of comebacks, right, Gazzy? It'd be a comeback of comebacks. If you and I collaborated again. So I want to know what Kush K means by heavy trader beef. Is he talking about the beef I'm having with Little Boy Blue right now, Controller FX? Because that's not a heavy trader beef. He actually has to have balls and a dick in order for it to be a heavy trader beef. But since he's a pussy, he wears girls' panties, and his balls are in his mom's purse, then it's not really heavy beef at all. At all. It's more like little baby beef. So when his balls drop and his voice gets when his voice gets deeper and he actually hits puberty and he stops trading from his parents' house in his bedroom, right? When he stops trading from his parents' house in his bedroom and then claim to make 20 to 40 grand a month, then we can have a beef. But right now it's not a beef. It's a little boy getting put in his place because he's a dumbass. That's just the bottom line, right? I mean, I'm sorry again that it hurts people's feelings, but there's no beef there. He gets crushed. I mean, do we have to go back to his trading nut challenge? Do we have to go back to that? We do this all the time, but do we have to go back to it? I kind of feel like we have to go back to it. He did the trading nut challenge, right? I did the trading nut challenge and he did the trading nut challenge and the results were really different. The results were really different. One person did really well in the trading nut challenge when they had to trade in front of an audience and one person sucked ass. One person sucked ass and one person did really well. Okay, so here he is with at the trading nut challenge. Okay, and this is all available right on YouTube, folks. You don't need to take my word for it. But you can see on there that on the Trading Nut Challenge, his account will start at 10,000, right?
Okay, so you got 10,000 bucks.
Yeah, he's got 10,000 bucks, okay? He's got 10,000 bucks. And at the end of the challenge, let's just look where it is.
Away from this, it's too close. Stop loss for sale, yep.
Let's just look where it is.
Can artificial intelligence make you money in 2022?
No, it cannot make you money in 2022.
Time's ticking, we're at 50 seconds.
Was this QBanks?
Q, full video and everything.
Yeah.
Anyways, it was a colossal. So he gets up to 10,300. So he's up 3.2%. But it's a colossal fucking failure.
Ranger Friday. I'll say roughly around this area here. That one.
He ends at like 9,820. He loses money. So again, there it is, right there. Okay. So the one time he has to effing trade in front of an audience, he loses. He gets his ass kicked. He loses 2%. It's all right there. You can just go look at it. I'm not telling you anything that isn't true. Right?
I found you've actually got a really good grasp of it compared to...
Okay, so he loses almost 2%, okay? Now let's compare that with other people.
I think I'm a close position there. 1 hour close...
So let's just compare that to other people, right? Other people, and let's see what it is. Okay? And again, don't take my word for it. Just go look at it, right? Just go look at it. Just go look at it.
All right. What's the current standing? So, Clay.
Oh my gosh! Look at the current standings. Look at the current standings on Trading Nut a year ago, when he did it too. Look at the current standings. Who is that there? No, you can't see it, right? Because my screen is a little bit messed up. Who is in control there? Who is the top spot? Clayton Hall. That's really weird. Let's listen to this for a second. That's really weird. I don't understand it.
Clayton Hall topped the charts again for the second.
Oh my gosh, listen to that. Listen.
Triggers, and then he can reduce. He can reduce the stop loss, but he can't extend it. So it's only 1 hour is what you're putting at risk here. And only 150% partial exit is allowed per trade. Rankings based on overall gain during the 5-trade challenge. Max stop loss 500 pips. The Clayton Hall rule.
And the Clayton Hall rule. Because I started trading the daily chart and just holding trades for like 2,000 pips. So they got pissed at that. So on the first challenge, I would just take a US 30 trade. And I would know that the US 30 never went below a certain point. I would just put that stop loss below a certain point. I would just ride it for like 18 months. And they got pissed. So they said it's a 500 point stop loss maximum, and they called it the Clayton Haller Ironman training rule. That was pretty funny.
It's fun. Like, I mean, you know, it's going to be difficult for you because you don't have colors on your bars normally, so you might struggle a bit. Dojis are ignored, and I decide them for
look at that! Listen to this, weird!
This is the current standing. So Clayton Hall topped the charts again for the second time at, hopefully you can see this with my pictures not in the way, 3.29. So he did it twice. The first time he did it, he massively
won. Massive stop loss. I beat the game.
The second time, he didn't. And he got about the same result. I think the first one was 3.87. He's now topping the chart at 3.29. Followed behind there with Philip Blum at 1.2.
And then, and if you were to add these, then you'd have he would be Controller FX would be between Paul and Avery Horton down here at the lower. He'd be at -2%. So the one time he had to trade in public where he couldn't hide behind TradingView. He actually had to take the trades and show his trades that he was taking. He got his fucking ass kicked. But I didn't. I did it twice, and I didn't get my fucking ass kicked. Just saying. Let's be real here, people. Let's be real. So there should be some serious red flags going on with that goofball. But let's focus on taking some trades, possibly. Please, can we focus on taking some trades? Please. Okay, so this creates a really, really, really interesting situation on oil. Because, right, yeah, in 2 minutes, you have a sell pattern on oil, right? Because that 15-minute candle, it has a wick at the top longer than the body of the candle, right? I think it's just blank now because it was where it was when it started. So let's watch it here for a minute. But there it is again. So there's the blue candle showing up, and it's becoming blank because it's right there. So now we have a possible sell pattern going down on gold, I mean oil, right? So what do? I'm up 44 points on my buy trade. Do I get out of my buy trade? Do I get out of a winning trade for a potentially winning trade? What's the answer to that? Because this doesn't happen all the time. Now you're getting to see things. Do I take a winning trade out and get into another trade on the opposite side for a potentially winning trade, or do I just keep my winning trade in and maybe move my stops up some more profit and let it go? So what's the answer? Inquiring minds want to know what the answer is. Actually, no, they don't. They really don't give a damn about us either. Inquiring minds don't give a damn about us either. But the answer to that is the only time that I won't take the trade when the pattern sets up, because that's going to be a sell pattern, is when I'm in a buy trade and I'm already up on the trade. I'm just going to hold this buy trade at plus 10. Maybe I'll move it up to plus 20. Right? I might do that. 98, 93. Let's do that. So let's move it up plus 20, but we're not getting out of the trade. We're just moving it up. We're tightening up our profits. And then if it comes back and gets us at plus 20, that's fine. But I'm not going to get out of a winning trade that's winning right now for a potentially winning trade, if that makes sense. So that would be the only time that I wouldn't take a trade that's based on my pattern that I like to trade. Does that make sense to everybody? Or am I just talking to my fucking self? It's possible that I'm just talking to myself. It's very, very possible. So let's see if it respects that pattern again. If you're not in a buy trade, this would be an absolute good time to sell it. I'm not. The only reason I'm not selling is because I'm already in a trade. Okay, the GJ doesn't have anything. The GA doesn't have anything. So again, there's a 15-minute candle and we don't have anything except for oil. But again, I'm not in oil because I'm already in a buy on oil up 50 points. So I'll take my chances on my buy. The worst case scenario is I'll make 20 points, which again is more money than more pips than they get in those other streams. So I'll take my chances with that. Does that make sense? Does that make sense to everybody? So while we're doing that, while we're waiting for things to happen, we'll go ahead and play our theme song again. But yeah, it was the high score on there for a while on Trading Up, but then he kicked me off his platform because I made fun of Uncle Ted before Uncle Ted was going to go on for his second turn. And you can see on the leaderboard, I don't, Uncle Ted wasn't real high on the leaderboard, but he was going to come in for his second interview with Trading Up, and that was the time when I was beefing with everybody, and I don't want to beef with anybody anymore. But so I kind of laughed and made fun of Uncle Ted that he was going to have him on there again. And so Uncle Ted canceled his Trading Nut interview, and Trading Nut got pissed at me, so he removed my challenge and basically removed me from his platform. I got deplatformed from his from his trading area. So that's kind of what the story was there. It was really actually kind of funny. Because heaven forbid you make fun of people, right? I mean, heaven forbid the gall of you to make fun of people, right? It just shows you that people don't have thick skin and they can't handle people going after them. And that's what that shows. And again, I have no beefs with any of them anymore. I wish everyone success. I hope everyone gets exactly what they want. Except for Controller FX. I hope he dies of gonorrhea and rots in hell. Again, that's a line from Ace Ventura movie. I'm just joking. Don't take me too seriously. But I hope he dies of gonorrhea and rots in hell. What I should do is I should stream opposite of hey, I'm a well are you part of the Don Vu group? Is that what you're asking? Is that the question you're asking? And you're asking a legitimate question. Is that what you're asking the Don Vu group? You're saying, hey, I'm well devious. I think I heard of them from their stream, so kind of new. Just wondering why you don't like the DVS guys. You're talking about Don Vu, right? Or Controller FX. Is that what you're talking about? Lee Cram. Right? That's what you're talking about? Okay, so let me explain it to you, okay? And I think that anybody that streams on YouTube that hides behind TradingView is a pussy. Okay, you notice what's up there on my stream right now, Lee Cram? Do you notice that my MT4 live platform with live trades I'm in right now, you notice that that's up on my stream, up on my screen, and you can see it, right? You see that? You see the trades I'm in right now? How many? One, two, three, four trades, up a little bit of money. So I don't like it when people hide behind TradingView. If they're so good at what they do, why don't they just show their MT4 platform? Why don't they just show it? If they're as good as they say they are, right? And I'm at the end of the day, I'm not sure. Maybe they are. But why not show it? You should be proud of that, right? You should be proud of the fact that you're an amazing trader. Why not just show your fucking MT4 platform? Why are you hiding behind TradingView? Why are you hiding? If you're really good at what you do, show everybody. You should be proud of that. I would be proud of that. I think that's awesome. But why aren't you showing it? Why are you scared to pull up your MT4 platform? Why are you hiding behind TradingView? It's a fair question, right? So there's that issue that I have with anyone who streams, not just him, anyone who streams that hides behind TradingView. I think you're a pussy. And I think you wear girls' panties. No, there's no privacy issues with MT4. Anyone who tells you that there's laws against it or anything is full of shit. No, there's no privacy. They like to trade with your money. They like you to be their bank account, I guess. And again, maybe they're as good as they say they are. But if they're as good as they say they are, why not just show the platform and show live trades you're in? Why do you hide behind TradingView? So that's one issue. The other issue is when you claim, like he claims, to make 20 to 40 grand a month. Really good income, right? 22-year-old making 20 to 40 grand a month, but he's streaming, Lee Cram, from his parents' house in his bedroom. He streams from his parents' house in his bedroom. That's why he has to lock the door, or he has to shut the door, because his parents may ask him to go do some chores. If you're making, and I'm just think about this for a minute. If you're making the kind of money that you claim to be making, and maybe you are, and you're 22 years old and you're living with your fucking parents, there's something really wrong with you. Grow a set of balls and get your own place, right? Well, he gets a lot more views than that. I mean, he gets a lot more views than 900. But again, that's the question I have is, if you're so damn good at what you do, show the fucking thing, right?
Yeah, I mean, blow the range
look, here, he's gonna say, this is gold sells for 120 pips. Well, where's your MT4 platform?
Blow the range, price to continue, push down now.
See, he's hiding behind TradingView. You're not showing a live terminal. And then you're saying, oh, look at this, look what I did. I don't see any live terminal there. Why don't you just show your live terminal? If you're so good at what you do, just show it.
Chat, I'm gonna move my stops to break even and close.
Well, I'm gonna move my stops to break even and close out 40. But how do we know that? Because you're not showing. And then he's gonna claim 120 pip winner, but he closed out half at 40. Do you see any red flags with that? So here, look, there's his room. Right there's the door. He trades from his parents' house. He trades from his bedroom in his parents' house. Now, that's all good and dandy. That's fine with me. Do whatever the heck you want. But then don't claim you make 20 or 40 grand a month. Get your own place, man. Grow a set of balls. So don't you think that maybe brings up some red flags? That possibly he's full of shit? Maybe? It would for me, right? I mean, I don't know. I mean, again, if you got 120, awesome, good for them. But don't fucking lie. Well, I know what you're saying about the culture, and I get that, maybe. I get that, but he was never born over there. He's lived in Canada his whole life. He's not. I don't know what his ethnicity is, and I don't really care. All people should be respected, no matter the skin color, no matter what ethnicity they are. But you've lived in Toronto all your life. I mean, the culture of Japan or whatever Asian culture, you've really never lived, because you've probably lived here your whole life. I'm just saying, there should be red flags. Everyone should be saying, wait a second, dude, wait a second. Why don't you just show your stuff? Show your shit. Show your shit. Ooh. Show your shit.
I'm closing fully here, chat.
Okay, that's my problem. That's my problem with anybody. It's not just him, but I like to have a little bit of fun at his expense, just because, and I can do what I want to. It's my stream. I can choose to be an asshole if I want to, right? But the difference is when you come onto my stream, what do you see there? What do you see on my stream, Lee Cram, or I might be bumbling your name, and I apologize if I am, but what do you see on my stream? Do you see a live terminal up right now? Do you see the trades we're in right now on my MT4 platform? Do you want to see that it's a live account too? So this is a curved screen, so I don't know why it doesn't show the whole thing, but do you want to see that's a live, if you look up to the top left, that's a live account. And it's a smaller account, right? I have multiple accounts. It's a smaller account, but that's a live account. And I'm showing my MT4 platform because I'm not a pussy. So that's my problem. If you're as good as you say you are, show your fucking trades. Why am I so stressful? What are you talking about? Why am I'm stressful? That's hilarious. I'm passionate about making sure that traders do some due diligence, right? I mean, these people are wanting you to spend money with them. I'm passionate about the fact that you should be doing your due diligence. But how are you just... I'm not angry. How am I angry? I'm glad you are in my mind and you can know how I'm feeling inside. What if this is just the way I talk? What if this is just the way I talk? I'm not angry all the time. I went to Alaska for 12 days. I've got an amazing fucking life. I went to Alaska for 12 days. I was home for 2 days, and I went to Hawaii for 2 weeks. I've gone to Hawaii and Alaska in the last 30 days and traveled my brains out, caught fish, sat on my ass at the beach in Hawaii. Like, I have the most amazing life. I'm not stressed. I just think that if you're going to charge people, because he charges people for signals, right? If you're going to charge people, you should be able to show people that you're successful in a live account. I'm passionate about what I do, and I'm passionate about making sure that traders that are getting into the industry do a little due diligence, right? Say, what, you know, again, like I'm saying, think to yourself, this guy's claiming, just hear me out. This guy's claiming to make 20 or 40 grand a month, right? $20,000 to $40,000 a month. Yet he streams from his parents' house in his bedroom. You're 22 years old. We can go on Craigslist and we can find you a place in Toronto that you can get your own place. Well, and that's fine. You do whatever you want. Tingus, I charge for my signals. And do you know why I charge for my signals? Because my time's valuable to me. My dad, who has more money than God, said, do you know what the most valuable currency is? It's time. You never get it back. So my time is valuable to me. So if I'm going to take time away from my family, if I'm going to take time away from my wife and kids, I'm going to charge your ass. And I'll never apologize for that. But yeah, there's no stress in me, bro. A healthy amount of skepticism. Just question things. Don't just take someone's word for it. Whenever I talk about my pattern or I talk about my way of trading, I say, go back test it. Don't take my word for it. Go back test it. I'm just a schmuck on the internet. Don't believe me. Go back test it. That's what I always say. I don't want you to believe me. Maybe you should believe bikini girls. You might want to believe them. You know, you might want to believe the dude with his hand on the bikini girl's ass. I don't know. Whatever you want to believe. I'm just trying to say, hey, take a step back and start to question things. And ask yourself, is this too good to be true, possibly? And most of the time you'll find that it probably is. Helicopter ride on the Nepali coast. I mean, again, I don't have a stressful life, dude. I have an amazing life. Look at that. Helicopter ride on the Nepali coast in Kauai. We were there 3 weeks ago on a helicopter ride on the Nepali coast in one of the most beautiful coastlines you'll ever see. I have an amazing life. I'm not doing this to brag. I'm just saying there's no stress in my life. Maybe a little bit. I mean, I have kids. You know, maybe there's a little bit of stress. But I have kids. Kids are stressful. Right? Look at that beach right there. We'll look at the charts here in a minute. Another 15-minute candle is closing. But look at that, dude. I mean, freak. Look at that amazingly beautiful world we have. And the wonders of this world. It's beautiful, man. Look at that. The rip current in that is insane, though. You don't want to swim in that water. That rip current will take you out and make love to you and never bring you back. There's a 15-minute candle close. Do we have anything on the 15-minute candle close? We don't have anything on gold. We don't have anything on US 30. I'm losing on the US 30. I'm up down 77 points on the US 30, but that's fine. I'm not worried about it. If I get stopped out, I get stopped out. That's the GJ. We don't have anything on the GJ, it doesn't look like, right? The 15-minute. Oh, so the pound Aussie is close, right? The pound Aussie is close. You have a little bit of a wick at the top, but you definitely have a tail on that 15-minute candle, longer than the body of the candle. So we'll take it. We'll risk it a little bit tonight. No risk it, no biscuit, right? We'll do it. But it does have a little bit of a wick at the top, but we're going to take it anyway. Because we're sexy as hell. So we'll take a buy on that. Well, yeah, that's what all of those, most of those YouTube streamers, that's exactly what they do. They buy high and sell low. Anyway, we always talk about, in my stream, we always talk about in every other trading you do, or every other investing you do in your life, you look to buy low and sell high. But then when we start trading, we invert that strategy and we look to, you know, buy high and sell low, and it's the wrong way to do it. But that's what they all do. They're breakout traders, right? They look for breakouts of the high, and then they buy it because all they're going for is 10 pips. Well, that's not the way that the big boys trade. I'm sorry if that hurts your feelings. Not really sorry. But that's not the way the big banks trade, and that's not the way the big boys trade. But most of these people don't have a fucking clue how they trade. So they just do it because they don't know any better. Okay, so that low on that 15-minute candle is at 176.62. I want to have my stops below that by a decent amount. So we're going to have my stops at 176.20. So it's going to be like a 60-pip stop loss. And everyone's like, oh my gosh, that's huge. Well, it's not really that big. Okay. I just want to give the trade time to breathe. And the reason I don't like scalping is because one little spike in the market, down or up, and you're out of the trade. And you say, damn it, I had the direction right, but I just didn't give the trade time to breathe, right? That's the problem I have with it, with scalping, is it just one little spike up or down in the market, and you miss out on the trade. You say, dang it, I had the direction right, but I just didn't give the trade time to breathe because I was a pussy and had a 10-pip stop loss. Okay, you got to give trades time to breathe, boys and girls. It's a good thing. Let them breathe. Christopher says, are you looking for your pattern around? I'm looking for my pattern wherever the hell it sets up, Christopher, to be honest. So which time frames do you prefer to use when looking for a good support and resistance level? I usually, if I'm not streaming, right, because I usually take all of my trades based off the 1 hour chart, right? The pattern on the 1 hour. But because when I YouTube stream, no one wants to sit and not have opportunities except for one time an hour. So with the 15 minute, we get four chances per hour. But the pattern that I trade will work on any time frame, any pair, stonks, crypto, any of that stuff. It'll work on all of it. Okay. But if I can get it in a major support and resistance level, obviously that helps, right? But I'm just looking for the pattern. That's all I'm looking for. I don't care. Now, if I can, like, for instance, gold, everyone, you know, when you look at a 5 minute or 15 minute chart on gold, it's a bearish, right? But if you look at the higher time frames on gold, the 4 hour, the daily, the weekly, and the monthly, they're all bullish. So if all the higher time frames are bullish, right, you want to look for opportunities to buy. You want to look for dips to buy. I don't care what price is, correct? So if all major time frames, the 4 hour, the daily, the weekly, and the monthly, is that pretty common that all four charts align in the same direction, or is it not really common? Who wants to answer that question? Is it rare that all four charts, the 4 hour, daily, weekly, and monthly, align in the same direction, or is it pretty common? Is it rare or common? We'll start playing the Jeopardy music. Do, 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 do. Is it rare or is it common that all four of those higher time frame charts align in the same direction? Do, 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 do. Do, do, do. But is it rare? It's rare. JT's exactly right. It's extremely rare. So if that pattern is happening, right, JT and everybody, don't you want to look for dips to buy? Because that's what the higher time frame chart tells you. And if you look at, if you look at a monthly chart, in order for this trend to change on the monthly chart, do you know where gold has to go? Do you know where gold has to go back to on a monthly chart in order for the trend to change? Probably back in November of 2017 at 1367. You guys probably can't see it on my chart, right? Because I don't like this, but that red area down there that I highlighted at 1367, the monthly chart would have to go down there in order for there to be a trend reversal on the monthly chart. Does that make sense to everybody? Probably not going to happen. It's possible, right? But knowing what's going on in the world, it's probably not a high probability that gold will go back down there. So pretty confident in the fact that the monthly is going to remain an uptrend. The weekly, what does the weekly have to do? In order to be considered a trend change on the weekly, all right, it would have to come down probably into the 1609 area from December of 2019 in order to be a trend reversal. So until that happens, I'm going to be buying dips. The daily would probably have to come down to um, 1761. Okay, so the point I'm trying to make is it's probably a high, not a high probability that gold on the higher time frame charts is going to change direction. Does that make sense to everybody? Does that make sense to everybody? So if that's the case, then why not look for buys, right? Dips to buy. I've been calling for dips to buy gold dips since 1700. I mean, I've been calling for gold to buy gold dips since like 1700. I've been doing it for almost 2 years. Then I'm Christopher, I would just follow the pattern at that point. But three of the four would have to align. But I mean, again, it doesn't matter. Like with the pattern I'm trading, Christopher, you can trade counter trend, right? You can still trade counter trend. You can still sell gold and you're going to do just fine, right? I mean, there's been amazing opportunities. I did one yesterday, several yesterday. Look, there was a sell here on gold. That candle right there had a wick at the top longer than the body of the candle with no tail at the bottom. It had a 1 hour candle close with a wick at the top longer than the body of the candle right there, right? You would have gotten in right there at 1917, right around that area, 1917. Look, you would have killed it. Killed it. And there's more opportunities on the sell side. Okay. But you can still take the sells. Just because counter trend doesn't mean you can't take it. But your expectations for what, you know, the amount of money you're going to make or how high, far it's going to go down probably should be different. But you can, the pattern I trade is 85% accurate no matter what. Any time frame, any pair, anything. And you're seeing it right now. You're seeing it in these trades that we're taking. And we took the oil trade based off of a 15-minute pattern, right? Yeah, we took this oil trade based on the 15-minute pattern right here. Okay, so we took the oil trade based off that. We took the pound yen trade was a trade based off of a, was it a 30 minute? Maybe it was either 15 minute. Right there. It's beautiful. Why wait for a pullback to end while you can get the profit from both trends? I fit your buddy. I just said, were you not listening? I just said you can absolutely sell gold. Just because the higher time frames are an uptrend doesn't mean, I don't know if you were listening, but I literally just covered that. You can still do it. Christopher, that is correct. You can still do it. I'm just saying your expectations for what to expect from that trade are going to change. That's all I was saying. But I took the GJ trade based off that 15-minute candle that had a tail longer than the body of the candle, and I'm up 60 points on it, right? There's that was a 15-minute chart, so that was 15, 30, 45, an hour, hour and 15, hour and 30, hour and 45. That was a couple hours ago that this candle formed that, and I took that trade, and I'm up 70 points on it right now. So I probably should set my stops on the GJ into profit. Okay, so I'm going to move my stops. I'm up on the GJ right now. I'm up 40 points. Okay, that's actually a different one. Yeah, there's obviously there's a method for it. If it's a US 30 trade, I always or initially put a 200 point stop loss on it. And again, I know people freak out, 200 points, that's crazy. But the US 30 is a beast, right? So I originally start with a 200 point stop loss on the US 30, but once I get up 50 points on the US 30, my stop loss is always moved to break even, right? And then if I get up 100 points on the US 30, my stop loss is at plus 20 or plus 30. But initially, my stop loss is always plus or 200 points on the US 30. On Forex stuff, it'll probably be 60 to 100 points, like on the GJ. This one was 100 points, but now I'm going to move it because I'm up, right? I'm up 60 points on it. So I'm going to move it to at least 162.78. So I'm going to make plus 20 no matter what. So on Forex pairs, usually it'll be 60 to 100 points or pips, however the hell you want to call it. I don't really care. So now, no matter what, I make plus 20 on GJ. Okay. Yeah, 100 points. Again, you can call it 100 points, 100 pips, whatever. And people call it whatever, right? You can call it whatever you want, whatever floats your boat. It doesn't really matter what you call it, right? I call it points, pips. On the US 30, I definitely call it points. So if you get in the US 30 at 35,000 and you're buying, your stop loss would be at 34,800. That's 200 points. But you can call it whatever you want. Yes, you know, call it your girlfriend if you want. 200 girlfriends. You know, that really isn't that important what you call it. So, but on the US 30, once I get up again 50 to 60 points, my stop loss is going to be at plus 10. And then I just keep moving my stops up. And then on Forex pairs, it's probably 60 to 100 points. And on indices, it's 200 points. Gold, it's 100 points. Or $10, right? So if you get into a buy at 1915, if you get into a buy on gold at 1915, my stop's going to be at 1905. No, because I trust my pattern. Christopher, I know I'm going to be right 85% of the time, so why would I close? No, I let my trades play out because, again, I'm not a pussy. And I'm not making fun of you. I'm just saying I know what my analysis is and I trust my analysis and I don't take partials out in down drawdown. No. In fact, if I'm not trading with people, if I get into it, let's say I get into a buy and it goes against me, I'll just add more. I'm a swing trader by nature, but I know that when I'm sending out signals and when I'm teaching people, they don't want to swing trade because it can get pretty intense. But a lot of the times I'll take trades and I won't have a stop loss on it because I like on gold, right? If I want to trade gold and swing gold, but I've just got to lower my lot size, right? So I can handle the swings. But I mean, there's times I won't have a stop loss at all. But if you know you're going to be right 85% of the time, it doesn't matter. You should, again, like we talk about all the time, you should be a robot, right? You should be a robot at that point. If you know you're going to be right 85% of the time, you should be a robot. There should be no question whether or not you're going to take that trade or not. So oil is giving us another signal, right? Oil is giving us another signal in 2 minutes here, possibly. That candle definitely has a tail longer than the body of the candle. So if we know that we're going to be right 85% of the time, we're going to lose 15% of the time, right? Because there's no system that's right 100% of the time. And anyone who tells you that is a moron and don't believe them. So no system is going to be 100% accurate. But if you know you're going to be right 85% of the time, do you take the trade? Do you take the trade if you know you're going to be right? The setup on this on the oil is going to be a tail longer than the body of the candle with no wick at the top on the 15-minute candle close. And if you get that pattern, you're going to buy it. Does that make sense? So it's a tail or doji or a hammer. People call it different things, right? I don't care what you call it. I just know it works. Okay? So we're going to get this candle close and I'm going to, guess what? Buy it again. Because why? Because that's what the pattern says to do, and I'm a robot. And if I lose, I lose. I'm okay with losing. Okay? I'm wrong a lot. I'm married. I'm a guy, right? And the two important phrases you learn when you're married and you're a guy is you're right and I'm sorry, because you're always wrong. So I'm not afraid to lose, and that's what's made me successful, is because I'm not afraid to lose a trade. My emotions will be the same whether I win on this trade or not, but we got to have our stops on this new oil buy. We've got to have our stops below the low of that tail, which is at 99.07. And I want it 20 to 30 points below that. So probably going to have it at 98.60. I'm going to go 98.60, which would be what, roughly a 60 point stop loss. 98.60, will that cover? I'll go 98.40. So it'll be 80 point stop loss. So where is this new one right here? Here it is right here. So I'm going to go 98.40. Will be my, so it's an 80 point stop. Okay. On the other oil trade, I'm already in profit. Okay, and if it goes down, I'm still going to make profit. We'll see what this one does. The US 30 also gave us the sell signal. So again, if we believe in the pattern, right? If we believe in the pattern and we believe that the pattern works, we are going to take that trade, right? So I'm going to enter another trade, obviously, on the US 30 as well. I already have one that's down. That's okay. Okay, so this stop loss is going to have to be above. I'm going to do a 100-point stop loss on that one. So this one's going to be at 34,220. Do you guys see this? We do no FOMO HOMO trading in here. We don't hide behind TradingView like we're talking about. We're not pussies. You see live trades in live terminal right now. And I don't hide behind TradingView because I'm not a pussy. Okay, and again, any streamer who can't do that and doesn't show you a live terminal while they're streaming, run the hell away from them. Okay, because they're pussies. How long do you hold a position, brother? Would you advise this to start someone with like a $100 account? I'll hold trades for days. I've held trades for weeks and months. I held a gold trade from 1782 to 2060 for like 4 months. But I'm always moving my stop, right? I'm always moving my stop. When I get into more profit, I always move my stop into more profit. Does that make sense? Maybe it does. Does that make sense? So once I get up again on the US 30, it's 50 points. Once I get up 50 points on the US 30, I'm going to place my stops at break even. If I get up 100 points, it's probably going to be at plus 20. On 4X pairs, it's probably plus 30. I'm going to move my stops to break even. And then I'm just going to keep moving it up as we go along, if that makes sense. Does that make sense? And then the market's going to have to get me out, right? The market's going to have to get me out of the account. I'm not taking it out. The market will get me out. Because I want to be there in case these trades, you know, make a huge run. I want to be in those trades. I've been in trades for 800 points. I've been in US 30 trades that made me 800, 900 points. But that doesn't happen, right, in 2 hours. You got to be patient. You got to hold it. But when you're not, again, when you're not a, you know, when you're not a 10 pip pussy scalper, like most of these streamers are, and you have balls, you know, your balls dropped, your voice is a little bit different now because you have a little deeper voice and your balls drop. When you're not a pussy, you're not afraid of holding trades longer. Only pussies scalp. I'm sorry, I shouldn't say that. I'm sure there's a bunch of scalpers in here and do whatever you want. But to me, only pussies scalp. Scalpers wear girls' panties is how I say it. And I'm not a pussy. My balls dropped a long time ago. My voice, you know, I took my balls back from my mom's purse a long time ago. But you'll never see them do what I'm doing right now. All those, you know, huge influencers, these Instagram influencers that do YouTube streams, you'll never see them pull up their MT4 platform while they're streaming and take trades in their MT4 platform. You'll never see it because they're pussies. I'm sorry to sugarcoat it for you. They're pussies because they're scared. They hide behind TradingView. Because they're not traders, they're marketers, and they're damn good at it. You know, they're damn good at what they do, but they're not traders, they're marketers. They don't want to put themselves out there like I'm doing right now. I mean, you guys could all just laugh your asses off at me. If all four of these, how many of trades do we have in here now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 trades, and all 8 trades went against me. You would have every right to laugh at me because I obviously didn't do a very good job of analyzing. But I'm not afraid to put myself out there. I'm putting it out there for everyone to see. I'm swinging that thing in the wind and saying, look at me, right? I don't care because I'm confident in what I do. And that's the reason I don't care. And if these people were so good at what they do, then why won't they show their live terminal? And that's what I always say. The advantage of being a swing trader rather than a scalping trader is when you're a scalping trader and you have a 10 pip stop loss, one little market manipulation can get you out of the market, right? One little spike in the market up or down and you're out, right? When you have a swing trade or you're holding your trades longer, you're not susceptible to little market manipulations. Does that make sense? But when you're scalping and have a 10 pip stop loss, one little market manipulation and you're out of the market, right? Whereas when you swing trade or you let trades breathe, you grow a pair of balls. You don't get knocked out of the trade with one little market manipulation, if that makes sense. Because we've all done it, right? We've all said, dang it, I had the direction right. My stop loss was just too tight. We've all been there. We've all been there. I've been there too. But the way I trade is I'm not going to be stopped out by little market manipulations. Does that make sense? Fit your buddy? And that's why I don't like scalping. I would rather get kicked in the balls than scalp. Because it's way too stressful, I think. One little market move and you're out. That's why I don't like it. But people can do whatever the hell they want, man. People can do whatever the hell they want. I don't really care. It's not my problem, right? So, but that's the reason I don't like scalping. Because I don't want to be pushed out of the market with one little market manipulation. I hope that makes sense. Okay, we got 8 minutes left in this 1 hour candle, and we'll switch these back to the 1 hour time frame. And the 1 hour time frame would be what I would be taking trades on if I wasn't streaming, like we talked about. But most people don't want to sit in a stream and only get one opportunity every hour. Some may say, well, that just shows you're completely undisciplined, Iron Man. Well, no one really cares what you think. So I like it on the 15 minute when I'm streaming. I like it because I can, you know, we get more opportunities. But if I was just trading on my own and not streaming, I wouldn't take 15 minute trades. I would just take 1 hour trades, if that makes sense. Something's happening. Something good's happening, maybe. If that makes sense. So, let's go see what those other goofballs are doing in that stream. The 4X Aaliyah stream, which is one of the dumber. I mean, these people are... This room is just full of idiots. I like to go in there and make fun of these people. I mean, again, you know, trading is boring. Everyone thinks that being a full-time trader is just this, oh my gosh, it's so amazing. But what they don't understand is 90% of the time, it's boring as hell. So you have to entertain yourself. It's boring as hell. Especially in the wintertime here in Idaho. I'm in the United States when it gets to like negative. No one wants to go outside in the negative. So you just sit around and make fun of people because it's fun and you can do it. And I'm good at it. It's a talent. I mean, I'm sorry that I have that talent. I wish I didn't, but I'm good at it. I'm good at the banner. I wish I wasn't. I wish I wasn't. I wish I was just this completely kind soul to everybody and just loved everyone with my deepest love and admiration, but I'm not that person. I really don't like people in general, to be honest with you. I'd rather just be left the hell alone. And that's why I don't like streaming on YouTube for the most part, but I do it just for fun. Okay, and the GA is looking like on the 1 hour, we could absolutely have, we already have a GA buy in there, don't we? Yeah, we're up on a GA buy already. But if this 1 hour candle closes in 5 minutes with that pattern, what am I gonna do? What am I going to do if this GA closes like this on the 1 hour candle? What am I going to do? Bueller, 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 Bueller. Let's watch that real quick. I'm going to take the damn trade because that's what the pattern says to do, right? No emotions, no anything. You just take the trade because that's what the chart tells you to do. That's what the candles, that's what the younger generation. That's what it tells you to do. So you're just a robot at that point, right?
See what's in store. It'll pop up and say, hey, this is within, you know, 3 miles of you. And that is huge for us.
Bueller.
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 Here.
Bueller.
Bueller. This goes on for like a minute. Bueller.
Bueller.
Bueller. Bueller. Goes on for like a minute. I'll get my stream kicked for that. But. So if it happens, it happens, and we take the trade because that's what the numbers and the pattern says to do, right? So we just do it because we're sexy bitches. I mean, I can't help that we're sexy bitches. But we are. I can't help it if we're sexy bitches, but we are. So we have 3 more minutes left in that candle. Let's look at the other ones too. Let's get a bird's eye view of the other ones. But that one looks really good. So we'll go back to the pound Aussie. Someone remind me if I forget to do that one. And look at freaking oil. So freaking oil is going to give us a sell signal. I'm in a buy that I'm down 21 points on, but I'm also in a buy that I'm up on. So that's going to be a little bit of a conundrum for me. Do I take a sell even though I'm in two buys? Maybe. Or do I just take the buys out, take the 20 pips, and take the sell? Choices, choices, choices. If I wasn't already in buys, I would take the sell, but I'm going to roll with the buys. But in 3 minutes, if oil, 1 hour time frame, closed like that, I would absolutely take the sells. But I'm going to roll with the buys because I'm in two buys. I'm up on one, and I'm net positive on my two positions on oil. So I'm going to, for better or worse, hold that position. But if that 1 hour candle closes like that on oil, that is absolutely the pattern I look for. Okay, does that make sense to everybody? If it doesn't, I don't give a damn. Don't really care if it does make sense to you or not. Okay, so we're focused on the pound Aussie right now. And if we get this pattern in, now these 2 minutes seem like it's taking forever. We get the pattern on the pound Aussie, then we'll take the trade. Pretty simple, right? I mean, it's the simplest damn trading you'll ever see in your life. It's the simplest trading you'll ever do. Seems like it's been 2 minutes, like 9:58 where I'm at for like 20 minutes. This 2 minutes is sure taking us dumbass time to to get there. So 9:59, so we have a minute left before this candle closes. I will absolutely take this buy trade. If I will absolutely take this buy trade. So we'll see what happens. And again, I might lose, right? I'm okay with losing. Because again, I know that the majority of the time I'm going to win. The majority of the time I'm going to win. So if I know I'm going to win at an 85% clip, I'm just going to take the dang trade because that's what the numbers say to do. So I will take the trade. Ooh, it's getting close. Getting close, damn it. Getting close, but it looks like it's going to give it to us. So we're going to go. Yep, there it is. Okay, so I'm doing it because that's what the numbers say to do. If I lose, I lose and I'm okay. There it is. And my stop losses need to be below 176.62 again. So 176.20. 176.20 will be my stop loss. And we'll see what happens. I might get my ass kicked, right? I don't know. And I'm perfectly okay with that. Okay, so we'll put that little baby away for a while because we're not paying attention to it right now. Oil was a sell. If you weren't in a buy, oil was absolutely a sell. Oil on the 1 hour time frame, if you look at that 1 hour chart, it is absolutely a sell. That wick at the top is longer than the body, right? If you look at the 1 hour oil, that's absolutely a sell. but I'm in a buy and I'm going to risk it with my buys for better or worse. I probably should take it to sell, right? I probably should take a sell position too. You know, I'm going to take a sell position because that's what the pattern says to do and I should do it. And I'm going to have a pretty tight stop loss on it. And if it stops, my two buys will end up making really good money, but I'm going to do it because the pattern's there. Okay, so on the sell, so now I'm in two buys and a sell. And so this one's about to take me out. The one I'm in 32 points profit is about to take me out. So one of my buys is about to take me out. I'll make money on it no matter what, which is good. But it's about to take me out at plus 20 on one of my buys. On the sell, I want my stop losses obviously below the, I mean, I want my stop losses above the high of the wick. So I want my stop losses, oops, I don't want to do that. Let's do this one. Let's move this one. Oops, jeez, come on. Mother trucker. So it's got to be above 99.49 at least. So we'll go 99.80 on that stop loss. And we'll see what happens. What I'm actually hoping happens is that the U.S. if oil ends up going down, what I'm actually hoping will happen is usually the U.S. 30 will follow that, right? Usually the U.S. 30 and oil align in the same direction. They'll go in the same direction. So if that happens, then the U.S. 30 will go down, and I have two sell positions on the U.S. 30 that'll make me good money. But right now I'm losing $53. I don't know what to do. It's so scary. What do I do? What do I do? I don't know what to do. Actually, I do know what to do. Just let these trades play out. Pretty sure that's all I need to do. So, anyways, does anybody have any questions? Because I'm going to go to bed here soon. I was up way too late last night. I was up till 3:30 in the morning in a stream. Then I had to get up at 7. So I'm going to try and get some sleep. Hopefully my acid reflux will allow me to get some sleep. But does anybody have any questions? Oh, I think we're gonna tighten up that stop loss to 99.60. We're gonna move it down by 20 points. Because if it breaks that 99.45 area, it should move up. So we'll move the stop loss on the sell to 99.60. There we go. Perfect. Yes. Probably, I don't know. Probably, I mean, I'll probably take positions in the. Hopefully not very often. Hopefully I won't be streaming very often. I hate streaming, to be honest with you. I really, really hate it. I hate it kind of with a passion. I kind of hate it. So hopefully not often. But if you like and if you subscribe to the channel, then it will alert you when I'm live. I don't care if you subscribe. Again, I don't care if you subscribe. I don't care if you like the channel. I really don't care because this isn't about, again, it's not about followers for me. It's not about anything like that. I make money trading, so I don't really care about that. If you want to dislike the stream, you can dislike it. I think I disliked it. So, but I don't really care about any of that stuff. If you want to dislike the stream or you want to follow me, that's fine. I don't get any thrill out of it because I make money trading. So we'll hold on here for a little longer. Maybe another 10 minutes. Go to another 15 minutes. Probably don't want to take a bunch more trades. I'm in how many right now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 trades right now. That's a lot. But that's because all of them are with the pattern, right? It's a lot. It's a lot to do. And I probably should just start taking some profit on the stuff I have profit in, and then hoping the other stuff plays out. But we'll give it a few more minutes, then I'm going to go to bed, sleep with the wife, fool around with her a little bit, see if she'll, you know, fool around with me a little bit. Probably not. She's probably asleep. She might be listening to the stream. You never know. Sometimes she sneaks in and listens and then says, "Why were you saying that?" No, my wife's amazing. I love my wife. It's our anniversary this week. 21 years. We've been married this week on the 28th. 21 years. She's my best friend. She's my heart and soul. Love that lady. She is an amazing lady. She puts up with me. I mean, anyone who puts up with me is pretty amazing to me. Right? Anyone who puts up with my crazy ass self is probably a pretty good person. Probably a pretty good person. Oh, she is a good person. I know that. So, and if she is listening, then I totally score brownie points. If she's listening and I'm talking very nicely about her. So that can only help too. So that can only help, right? If I'm saying nice things about her, it can only help my chances of getting some action. Right? Action Jackson. It can only help my chances if I talk nicely about her. Yeah, 21 years. We got 5 kids. Our oldest is 19. We're Mormon, right? So my son's on his 2-year mission out in Richmond, Virginia. And then my next son will be turning 17 in a week. 17 a week, and he'll be going on his mission in a year. So my oldest son will get back from his mission, and then my second son will leave on his mission like a month after my other son gets home. And so we got a 19-year-old, a 17-year-old, a 13-year-old, an 11-year-old boy, and then our youngest is an 8-year-old girl. And she has dad wrapped around her finger. She's got me wrapped around her finger. She gets whatever she wants. She just bats her eyes at me, and so I'm like, "I'm sold. What do you want?" So my wife's like, "Why did you go get candy with her again?" Well, look at her. Look at her little face. Why wouldn't I? Why wouldn't I go get candy with her? Look at that face. But what? And my wife has finally figured out the ruse is I want candy just as much as my daughter does. So, I mean, maybe even more. So it's not like I'm doing any difficult thing because I want the candy too. So, but my wife's figured that out. She's like, "You want it more than she does." Yep, I do. I do indeed. I do indeed. Indeed. Very much so. But we have fun. We have a great life. And the most important thing to me are my children and my wife. Those opinions of me only matter when they're the opinions of my wife and kids. I could care less what anyone on YouTube thinks of me. I could care less what anyone on Instagram thinks of me. Because, again, you're relevant in people's lives, right? You're relevant in your parents' lives, your friends' lives, people who you communicate with on a day-to-day basis in person, right? Because social media is just fake ass. But I'm not going to meet most of you, right? I'm not going to meet probably 100% of you ever. So why would I care what people that I'm probably never going to meet, why would I care what their opinion of me is? I just don't care. I care what my wife thinks of me because I have day-to-day interactions with her face-to-face. I care what my kids think about me. My 13-year-old would probably say, "Yeah, you're not very nice because I have to follow rules." But so I really don't give two flying craps what anyone on social media thinks of me. I'm kind of the black sheep, and I enjoy that role, to be honest with you. I'm calling out stupid-ass traders. I'm calling out who I think are clowns. I've been doing this for 18 years. I've traded for 18 years for a living. I've been in the game for a long time. I enjoy my role as the black sheep. Because then you get messages from people like ControllerFX. Again, we always like to mention him. But then you get messages from him on Instagram saying, "Oh, will you please stop lying about me?" And it's great. Look, we get messages from Little Boy Blue, ControllerFX. Right here, private message that he sent earlier today. Let's go look at it again. He's like, "Listen to this." He's like, "Listen, Iron Man, stop spreading lies.
This was your reply, not whatever you posted. Stop spreading lies. Little boy blue. Don Vu. Stop spreading lies about me. You mean the fact that you trade from your parents' house in your bedroom? Fact. The fact that your trading nut challenge was a complete colossal disaster? Fact. So what exactly am I lying about? Those two things are true. So I ask him, yes or no, you trade from your parents' house? Simple question. Yes or no, your trading nut challenge was a disaster? Those aren't lies. Those aren't lies, kid. It's the truth. I'm sorry you can't handle the truth. Stop spreading lies about me. No, there are truths about you. You do stream from your parents' house, and your trading nut challenge was a colossal disaster. Just own it, man. You know, own it. Own it, dude. Own it. Because it's just a fact. So I didn't lie about you. I told the truth about you. And you didn't like it, so you had to send a private message. Please stop. Please stop. My delicate feelings are being hurt right now. Because I care what some schmuck on the internet is saying about me. My delicate feelings. Right? My delicate feelings. Damn it. They're hurt. Because you said something mean about me. You mean tweeted like Trump. You mean tweeted. And I always say, if you can't handle mean tweets, or if you can't handle the arousings of a moron like me on the internet, you're never going to be able to handle the markets. The markets will spit you up, chew you out, laugh at you. They don't know your name. They don't know my name. I've been doing this for a long time. The markets don't know my name. The markets don't care about me. So grow a pair of balls. Stop complaining. Go ask your mommy for your balls back from her purse, like I always say. And just grow a pair of balls. Let your voice drop. Have your balls drop and, you know, hit puberty and then come back and talk to us. Okay, so the GDP Aussie is not working on the 1 hour time frame. But good thing we're not sissies, because how many pips are we down on the pound Aussie right now? How many pips are we down on the pound Aussie by? 7 or 8 pips. Good thing we're not 10 pip pussies. Good thing our balls did drop and our voice did get deeper. Deeper. Because if they didn't, then that would really suck. Because we would have to get out at 10 pips like pussies. Sorry, that hurts your feelings. No, again, I'm not sorry. Okay, 2 more minutes. And it looks like this oil is going to give us the damn pattern to the buy side again. So do you take the trade? Do you take the trade on oil on the buy side? Do you take the trade? Yes or no? 10 pip pussies. That's right. I should make a song about that. I should do a rap about that. Grand Theft. 10 pip pussies. I should do a rap song about that. I should do a rap song about that. My older son's coming in. I'm gonna do a rap song about that. I'll have that out soon. 10 pip pussies. That's what we'll call it. 10 pip pussies. 10 pip pussies. Here we go. Let's get ready for this. Here we go. Oh my gosh, look at that. That candle gave us what we were looking for. Okay, we're buying oil again. This is a lot of trades to be in. And I'm down $67. Should I cry? You send me some beats, dude. Absolutely. I'm all for it. Absolutely send me some beats. Bruh, send me some beats. We're gonna make a song, 10 pip pussy trades. I wear girls' panties because I'm a 10 pip pussy trader. I think that I totally should do that. Yeah, please do. I totally want you to. I totally want you to send me that. Is that wrong? Is that wrong of me to want you to do that? Is that wrong? So yeah, send me some beats, man. Send me some beats. Some bait baits. Okay, so we got a buy. So we got three buys on there now. We got three buys on there. We're really getting just jiggy with the oil buys. We're getting jiggy with them. Okay, so that one's at 99.20, 99.08. All right, 98. We'll go 98.70 on this one. 98.70 on that stop loss. We could lose some money here, guys. We could lose a couple $100. That wouldn't be fun. But it's just the way it goes. That's the way the cookie crumbles sometimes. That's the way the cookie crumbles. Yeah, send me some sick beats. Just like Taylor Swift, right? You could have been getting down to this sick beat. I will definitely get my YouTube streams banned for this, but... we'll definitely get it banned, but that'll be okay. Because I'm going to go anyway. If we pause it every second, does that mean we get... if we pause it every 10 seconds, does that give us more before YouTube sees it and bans me? Here, I think it's right here. I think it's right here. It's coming up. We're just going to keep pausing it so they don't hear it and it starts our little thing again. Here we go. Here it is right here. This sick beat. Let's do that again. She really gets after it right there. Hey. Just think, while you've been getting down and out about the liars and the dirty cheats of the world, you could have been getting down to this sick beat. Yeah, you could have been getting down to this sick beat. Just remember that. You could have been getting down to this sick beat. Awesome. Right? I love Taylor Swift. I'm a big Tay Tay fan. I mean, there's this one song she has that, and she's at the Victoria's Secret fashion show, and she could be like a model in it. Let's see, Taylor Swift. I mean, she could absolutely be in that show. She looks that good. Let's see, right here. This is the one right here. I mean, it's just this one's just like, dang.
Will a faster, more reliable internet from Sparklight, now with double the speed.
Woo. Next to me, and I read.
mojo is on me. Cause I knew you were trouble when you walked in. Yes, Grand Theft, it should sound like Shake It Off, absolutely. I mean, she could be in that show. She looks that amazing to me. Whatever. We got to focus. Focus, folks. Yes, but you should definitely do it to Shake It Off. And we should edit it to show, you know, the streamers that I talk about all the time. We should definitely edit it to show that, you know, them. Rihanna? No, let's, all right, let's look at that. I'm not a fan. I'm not a fan, but we will look at that. That was really good, though. Is it the 2019 one or is it the 2012 one? Because it looks like there's two of them. Was it the 2019 or the 2012? Raymond, was it? Which one was it? Was it 2012 or 2019? 2012, it's this one. Let's check this out for a minute.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage.
That's pretty good. I like that beat. I do like that. I do like that. I'm not going to lie to you. I do like that. That's pretty cool. All right, we got to get some of these trades to start moving down. And the one that we can really get to start moving down is the US 30. So let's see. I'm going to stay here. I keep saying I'm going to take off, and then I don't. But I'm going to try and take off here at 10:30, which would be in 7 minutes. Let's see if we can get this US 30 down a little bit. Because I've got two sells on the US 30, one I'm down 76 points on, and another one I'm US 30 sell, I'm down six points on. So let's see if we can, you know, we can get the big boys to push this US 30 down a little bit. GA struggling, yeah, that's fine. Like I said, every now and again you're going to lose on trades, right? You're going to lose on trades every now and again. You can't win them all, and we don't expect to win them all. But, I mean, we say it's struggling, right? But it's down 15 pips. I mean, to me, that's nothing, right? To some people, it is. It's something, but it's down 15 pips. I mean, that, to me, that's nothing. Or is there another one that's down more? Oh, it's down there's one down 20 and one down 15. That's nothing to me. That's I don't care about that. But so it's struggling, yes, but it's not catastrophic. Nothing's catastrophic. But yeah, if you can do some sick beats, should it be to Shake It Off? And then just start showing all those people. I look at, so the first thing I do when I come into the market, I'm going to look at my 4-hour chart. I look at the higher time frame charts because I really don't care about the lower time frames. I don't usually trade the lower time frames. I'm going to look at the 4-hour chart, the daily chart, the weekly chart, and the monthly chart, and I'm going to try to establish what the higher time frame trend is. Does that make sense, Lee Cram? And if I can align three of the four higher time frame charts in one direction, I'm going to look for trades in that direction. Does that make sense? So if I can get three out of the four higher time frame charts, the 4-hour chart, the daily, the weekly, and the monthly, if I can get three out of the four to be going in the same direction, I'll probably be looking for trades in that direction. Does that make sense? And then I'm going to scale down to my 1-hour chart to get entries. Okay, because I don't want to wait for the 4-hour, the daily, the weekly, or monthly. So I'm going to scale down to my 1-hour chart. In this case, because we're trading on the stream, we even scale down. But I take most of my trades based off the 1-hour chart. But my analysis is done on the 4-hour, daily, weekly, and monthly. I don't do analysis on the 15-minute unless we're taking 15-minute trades on here based on the pattern. I don't do any analysis. I think the 5-minute chart, the 15-minute chart, I think they're just noise, market noise, right? That's what I think. That's my personal opinion. I think they're just market noise, and I think they're kind of worthless. But because we're doing this stream and we're taking trades in here, I want to have opportunities to, for you guys to see that the pattern works no matter what, no matter what one you're trading, if that makes sense. So I determined my bias for the day by going to the higher time frame charts. And you know, you'll go into those YouTube streams that are like, oh, gold's a downtrend. Well, yeah, you're looking at a 5-minute chart, but who fucking cares about a 5-minute chart? Nobody. Nobody cares about a 5-minute chart. Nobody cares about your stupid EMAs that you're using. Nobody cares about FIBO levels. No one cares about that crap because it's just garbage lagging indicators. I have no indicators on my chart. I don't need them. But I go to the 4-hour chart, the daily chart, the weekly chart, and the monthly chart, and I determine my bias from that, and then I scale down to the 1-hour chart to take entries. Does that make sense? I mean, it's the easiest thing in the world. Hopefully that makes sense. It looks like gold might give us an opportunity here on the 15-minute on a buy pattern as well. The US 30 is just being stubborn as hell. So it doesn't want to come down for sure. But it looks like gold is a possible setup here in 3 minutes. And then after that, I'm going to take off, guys. I'm going to go to bed. And I'll let these trades play out the way they play out. And if I lose money, I lose money. I don't care. But you guys can see I'm different. I'm different than most streamers because I'm not afraid to show you a live terminal because I'm not a sissy. Right? I'm not a sissy. I'm not afraid to show you live terminal, live trades, and not afraid to lose. Because again, losing's going to happen. Losing's a part of the game. You're never going to avoid it. Anyone who tells you they never lose or their system never loses, you run the hell away from them. I'm getting older now. I don't run very fast. So when I'm chased, I don't, you know, maybe they'll catch me because I'm not very fast anymore. I'm getting old, you know. But you run away from people. If they can't, you know, if they tell you their system is 100%, you need to run away. Run away and never look back. All right. Perfect, right? Okay, so again, 2 more minutes left in this, and gold is looking really nice for a potential buy. And that tail is longer than the body on the 15-minute candle. But we'll see. We'll give it a chance here and see what happens. And then I'm going to bed, folks. I am going to bed. Hopefully my wife is still up. We can hang out a little bit before bed. She might be dead to the world at this point. So that's coming down a little bit on gold. You notice how it's coming down in the last 1 minute. So is that right now it's not longer, right? It's not longer than the body of the candle, so I wouldn't take that. It was looking like it was going to give us that pattern, but right now it doesn't look like it is. Lee Cram, where else would I be doing my analysis except for MT4? Where else would I be doing it at? Oh, gold is going to do it. Look at this. Gold is going to pop up possibly here. I thought the 15-minute might do that, but gold is going to possibly give us that pattern. So where I don't understand where else I would be doing that analysis. I mean, I think I know where you're going to say, but where else would I be doing it? Where else would I be doing it? I know what you're going to say. You're going to say TradingView, right? Why aren't you doing your analysis on TradingView so you can mark up your charts? Because that's what everyone else does. They do TradingView. If that's the what you're going to say, my response would be because I don't need fucking TradingView. TradingView is a waste of time to me. It doesn't make me money. TradingView is the biggest waste of time. But people are like, well, you want to journal your stuff? You want to mark up your charts? Do this? You know what my journal is? Do you know what my journal is? It's called my trading history, my account history. I can go look at that anytime I want to. I don't need TradingView. I think TradingView is for sissies. I have everything I need right here. But that's just me. That's my personal opinion. You do whatever you want. But I don't need TradingView. Well, I mean, we kind of did that, right? We kind of did that. We go, my analysis again, when I know you've been here for a long time today. I know we went over this. I'm going to look at the 4-hour chart. The first chart I'm going to look at when I come into the market, the 4-hour chart, I want to know what the trend is. I'm going to look at the daily chart. I want to look at the weekly chart. I'm going to look at the monthly chart. I want to know what the trend is on those four higher time frame charts. And if I can get 3 of the 4 higher time frame charts aligned in the same direction, I'm going to be biased to that, to buys or sells, depending on if it's right, the higher time frame charts are bullish or bearish. And then I'm going to scale down to the 1-hour chart, and I'm going to take trades based off the 1-hour chart. It's that simple. So I do analysis on the 4-hour, daily, weekly, and monthly. If I can get 3 of the 4 to align in either the sell direction or buy direction, then my bias for the day will be in that direction, and I'll scale down to the 1-hour chart to look for trades. Really simple. It's the simplest way of trading you'll ever see in your life. And then I wait for my pattern. Forex funding. Are you talking? Yeah, you're talking about funding accounts. I don't know. Anyways, guys, if you don't follow me on Instagram, this is the one shameless plug I will do. Follow me on Instagram, Iron Man Futures Trading. And I do have a hater account. I love him. Iron Man Futures Trading is a scam. I love the guy. I always say during my streams, if you don't have a hater account, then you're not doing anything important. Okay, if you don't have someone that's hating on you, you're not doing anything important, because it's called the crab in the bucket theory. When one crab starts to get out and escape the bucket, every one of the other miserable crabs wants to drag that crab down because it's being successful. So if you don't have a hater account, then you really aren't doing anything important. So Iron Man Futures Trading is my Instagram account. You can see it right there. You can follow me there. I do have a paid signal service. You're a funded futures. That's awesome. I do have a paid signal service. My win rate on the signal service is like 90%. You also get 6 one-on-ones with me. But the really cool thing that I'm doing now, is when you spend the $400 for a lifetime membership for the signals, it's my money at that point, right? Because you're paying for my signals. But I will invest the $400 in an account, and we'll split the profits 50-50, and I will give you the investor password. So that's pretty cool. So you're going to get a lot of perks for doing that. And I will give you the investor password, and you can always keep your eye on it. So just so one more time, just to repeat that to you, if you join my signal service, the best signal service out there, we've already made over 1,000 points this week, excuse me. It's the best signal service out there. You'll get a lifetime membership. You'll get 6 one-on-one sessions with me for an hour that I record and send to you, and we will split the profits. To me, that's pretty freaking sweet. You won't find a better deal out there. You won't find a better deal. So if you want to get in touch with me about, and you have a 30-day money back guarantee as well. So if you want to get in touch with me, send me a message on Instagram, Iron Man Futures Trading. Other than that, guys, I'm going to take off. I am just extremely tired. I was up till 4 in the morning, and then I had to go do some stuff at 7 a.m. So I got about 2 hours of sleep last night. It's almost 11 o'clock at night here. I am going and dragging my ass to bed. Okay, so everyone have a great night. There were some really good trades we took. The oil trade was a DC we call banger trade. The oil trade was really good. We took. There's a couple trades that we're down on right now, but it's okay. Our stop losses are where they need to be, so I'm not really worried about that. We'll let these trades run and see what happens during the evening. So, all right, everyone have a great night, and we will talk to you mother effers tomorrow.